for 5 days it was independent before it took the step to merge with what was then the trust territories of Italian Somaliland, historic Italian Somaliland, to form a union. Both nations entered that union with optimism, with a sense and a view of creating a pan-Somalia, of where all Somalis would able to come together. And actually the hope was for so many of those in Somaliland that actually this would be a union of
the parliamentka ingriska walaga deqati de Somaliland in ingris kusudo yotraf ka Somaliland
were not fulfilled.
هل شعب المرنا خرالو صعانيا عدو توجيني مر في فاسمال
mass killings where tens of thousands of Somalilanders were killed, civilians were killed.
Yes.
It was one of the few conflicts where fighter jets took off from cities in the area in order to thousands of civilians.
And law abiyinba tadkhalo lay.
I'll give way to you on the board later.
And for securing this very important debate, my constituency has a very large Somaliland population of those from Somaliland whose families suffered in, as he's described, in those, that conflict. What we've seen is last year Somaliland celebrated 30 years of the Declaration of Independence, and they've built up their own independent government, own currency, and democratic elections. They've shown the capability to establish a state. Isn't it time, in his view, that the UK government formally recognise their right to self-determination?
Somalia would be able to say any dual noto, the Chira and Nogan, any Heligal Garden in the traveller. Very good point.
Key point and reason for this debate to actually discuss about the fact that Somaliland has developed so much. Because in those years of conflict, where so many Somalilanders were not just in the threat of their lives, but so many hundreds of thousands were displaced, both internally within Somaliland, but also externally. That dream and that vision of actually creating borders, burnt bright, and that is what they actually were able to achieve in
the
giving way.
Very good points.
And of course, so many people who live within his constituency. And of course, in his constituency is a very established Somaliland community that's been there far longer than probably either he or myself have been on this earth. And so this country has deep, deep links with Somaliland that goes actually not just back many decades, but goes back a century and more with many Somalis.
Yeah, oo kaalay UK iyo Soomaaliland inay xiriir qoto dheer leeyihiin oo waqti dheer ah. Okay, Somaliland waa waxa qejini ka weeyda in message go reey ba ay Somaliland ku akhri seen wada kana ay joonu wiire iyo kala galay. Great. This history.
Taking the brave step to
recognise Somaliland, we're actually not just opening up opportunities for Somaliland itself, we're actually opening up opportunities for British investors, British business to go there and work, very much creating the gateway to the whole of the Horn of Africa. I will give way to my right honourable friend and then my right honourable friend.
I'm very grateful indeed to my right honourable friend who has brought this most important subject to the floor of the House. Can I tell him that I have visited Hargeisa when I was Secretary of State for International Development, and indeed we spent quite a lot of time on exactly the issues he and the chairman of the
There is an enormous degree of normality there.
The democratic structures, when they have elections, have held in extraordinarily difficult circumstances.
Wonderful.
There is proper governance. I've travelled on a bus in Hargeisa that was a result of British investment. And the case he's making about Somaliland becoming an
international state, in Hurida, Somaliland, yeah, democratic, in Upasu Raiva. Good.
But is he aware that the African Union is at least passively acquiescent in that view, if not actively supportive?
Good.
On both areas that my right honourable friend raises, he's absolutely right. You know, you fly into Hargeisa Airport, it is a safe place in order to be able to visit. You can get a bus to the centre of Hargeisa, as my
إني ود المؤمن ويهي يعديني كني مقتاي برضو تظهر كسودي وبصور رعبة كيس ونف أنا ما بسوق يا أبوي الموت فلينا بركة ما بصرع very good Very interesting point, Padre.
Going into Djibouti, and the fact that actually where there is a vacuum, others do step in. And by showing the leadership that this country can show, by recognising Somaliland, actually it shows to those Somalilanders, it shows to the government of Somaliland, the value that we put on their friendship and their partnership. I give way to my right honourable friend.
I'm very grateful to my right honourable friend. I commend him for this debate, and I'm honoured to represent a Somaliland community in Swindon. Just building on the points made by right honourable members about the strategic importance of Somaliland, particularly its proximity to international shipping lanes. And we all know from British leadership and our good friend the noble Lord Hague, this country led the way in dealing with the issues of
imbigu ka yahay inuu ka socdo oo matalayo shicibka reer Soomaaliland ee xaafadda imbigu ee deggan. Great.
My right honourable friend is absolutely accurate in his assessment, and already, as we, even though we're not in a position where we've recognised Somaliland, we already have that level of cooperation with the Somalilanders. Visiting Somaliland when I was Defence Secretary, I saw firsthand the cooperation that British forces were already having with Somaliland in terms of supporting them in protecting their coastal waters, but also by protecting their coastal waters, keeping them safe for the international community. I give way to the Honourable Lady.
Thank the Honourable Member for giving way and thank him for securing this very important debate and commend the government for the support it's been providing the administration of Somaliland. Liverpool Riverside has a very long established Somali community and Somalilanders. And I'd like to know whether the Honourable Member will join me in calling for the UK government to support a binding referendum within 2 years to allow Somalilanders to express their democratic will guaranteed by the international community.
speaker. I'm not sure if you're an expert on Somaliland affairs, but it is the opportunity for you to sort of brush up on them this afternoon. The Honourable Lady makes an important point, but there's already been a referendum in Somaliland. This has been absolutely clear as to what the wishes of the Somaliland people
Good
are.
Point.
And that they want to see recognition, that they want to be independent, to have that independence.
Yes.
But I'm sure if that is what is a hurdle that is required in order to be able to establish international recognition for Somaliland, that is something that the Somaliland government may wish to.